This is Australia, 30 years ago, and that's me. At age 11, I got hold of the 1987 All-Star Game on VHS. It was the first NBA game I'd ever seen, and it blew my mind. Magic, Bird, MJ, Isaiah, McHale, Dr. J, the legends were all there to play. But here's the moment I'll never forget. No time left on the clock, the West down by two. Rolando Blackman at the free throw line, Zeke in the background talking trash, and Rose sending the game to overtime screaming, "Confidence, baby, confidence!" On the 30th anniversary of the 87 All-Star Game, I set out to get the story behind one of the most iconic moments in All-Star history.
It felt to me, watching it, that even though it was an exhibition game, everyone wanted to win. No one wanted to concede any ground.
No, it's a little bit different. We were getting inside of everyone's jock and making sure that you earned your all-star spot. I mean, it was a game, and it was a tough game to play with real defense.
Back then, they played hard, and they wanted to win the basketball games. It was really, really competitive between the East and the West.
You know, it was an exhibition game. However, we all came to the game, and all of us were highly competitive.
5 minutes to go. The West is down by 12. Pat Riley puts you back in. You guys go on a big run. Did you think it was possible at that stage that you were going to come back and make it a close contest?
Absolutely. You know, we had Magic Johnson, and we had guys in the game, Rolando Blackman, myself, who wanted to run.
3 seconds to go. Kevin McHale actually misses a shot. Moses gets a big tip in. The East take the lead, and the West call a timeout. Pat Riley calls a timeout. What was the play he said in the huddle? What was the play he drew up?
Well, the main factor with that was that he had a play that had different options of Magic coming to get the ball at the top. He had ball going to different areas of the court so that people could have a chance to turn around and move. I was coming through the last option on the side to be able to, if everybody was guarded, to come up to the side and get the ball. And lo and behold, I popped hard, got the basketball, turned, saw Bird, and did what I was supposed to do, which was go straight to the bucket and see if I could put the ball in the hole. And got attacked by three players and got slammed.
A foul is called with no time remaining.
I thought he was gonna pump and then take it back.
Right.
But he didn't take it back because I was trying to go behind him and smack it. But I think I smacked him in the head.
When did you realize that you had to hit two free throws to save the game?
As soon as the foul was made and I heard the buzzer simultaneously go off. That's exactly why I just went into a cocoon myself. I understood what was happening, and you could see me. I can remember the time walking to the free throw line, looking down at the ground, trying to compose myself.
He's the guy that folds his socks, you know, everything's gotta be neatly tucked in, everything's gotta be tight, you know, he's gotta, you know, and the seams on the ball has gotta be right, his fingernails gotta be cut right. I mean, everything has to be just like perfect.
Right. Putting my hand on my forehead to make sure that my fingertips were wet so the ball would grip. Just going through the process of getting myself ready to put these free throws down while hearing all kinds of stuff from Isaiah.
If I could just rattle him a little bit, right?
Yeah.
And Magic knows what I'm trying to do because everybody knows how Ro is. Yeah.
Could you hear Isaiah, what he was saying, or was it just sort of noise and just you just could hear that familiar voice even if you couldn't actually make out what he was?
No. I heard the words that he was saying, and some of them were very, very tough for sure.
And he's like dead serious. I mean, not giving me no rhythm, no eye contact, and, you know, nothing.
Sometimes he'd be yelling and screaming, and Magic would be covering up his mouth, going, whoa,
forget him, Ro. Don't listen to him, Ro. You gonna knock it down. Knock him down, baby. Knock him down, Ro.
When no one's on the court, it's a little bit of a different feel. So just trying to concentrate on the rim, put the basketball up to the circle that I see, making sure that it's an arc form, that I can get to the point I'm looking at, release the basketball up and over, and it hit the front, hit the back, and jumped in. Boom, I knew I had the distance then.
And his face was like, yeah.
As soon as I finished that, I could hear him and Magic laughing loud. It was a special time, but also it was something that I knew that my life was on the line. I knew it then, and I wanted to make sure that I come through.
But that's how competitive we were, but yet that's how much fun we wanted to have.
When you get the second one, it was an important feast because you can feel again. It was the confidence or nerves. Which one was it going to be? Confidence or nerves? So I decided to go confidence, baby, confidence. In my head, confidence, baby, confidence, confidence, baby, confidence, confidence.
It was like, I'm not listening to anybody. I'm going to block it out. I'm going to focus. I'm just going to knock this free throw down.
As I did the dribbles, put the basketball up. And I knew I had the distance. As soon as I released it, I said, confidence, baby.
It's just me, you, in the basket. Oh, baby, yeah.
Let out a yell of confidence because I wanted to release all the pressure. It was so much inside of me built up, turned around and went to the bench, and it was so much fun to get all the high fives from some of the greatest players that have ever played the game. So it was a special, special time, believe me.
Well, everybody's so excited. I mean, so excited. Like I had mentioned, the East had been kind of dominating the All-Star games, and we had an opportunity now to go over into overtime with momentum on our side.
And for me, it was just a special time simply because when you get into that moment and you're able to come through, it just galvanizes everything. It puts a stamp on the person that you are and the player that you are in that instance.
Well, you were under pressure 30 years ago, and you came through in the clutch. What if I put you under pressure right now and we go out into the court and you have to hit two more free throws? Do you think you can do it?
I still have the stroke. I still can stroke. I still have the stroke. I can shoot the basketball.
Well, I've been waiting 30 years for this, Ro. I've got a ball. Let's go, man. Let's go.
Let's go take it out, man.
Let's go do our thing.
There's two shots to make it. Your life is on the line. Your life is on the line.
Isaiah's in the background. Shut him up. Shut him up. Magic's blocking out. What's going to happen?
Confidence, baby.
Confidence! Do you think I can do it? Do you think I can replicate that moment?
Sure you can. All you got to do is concentrate on the things you know. Up and over, keep it straight, look at a point, and put a circle over it into the basket. Concentrate on that only. Confidence, 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 baby, confidence, confidence.
Confidence, baby, confidence!
Release all that tension. You can feel the release.
Thanks so much, man.
Pleasure's mine.